Charles Manson shocked the world. Now it's 4 decades ago, if you can believe that, when he and his followers killed 7 people in cold blood, including Roman Polanski's pregnant wife, the actress Sharon Tate. Now his cult's ranch in Death Valley will be closed for a second time in a year to search for human remains. So after this long, what might they find? Joining us for Forensic Friday is forensic pathologist Dr. Michael Bodden, Fox News contributor. Good to have you back. So when you've got bodies that potentially could have been there for 40 years, what do you look for in a bunch of dirt?
Bodies are terrific in sticking together. In dirt, at least the teeth and the bones will be good after 40 years. Sometimes flesh is also good if it's dried out. So that there's an awful lot that can be determined from exhuming somebody not only 40 years old, but 200 years old.
Yeah. Now, the Death Valley, of course, extremely hot. I assume that works in the favor of the people who are investigating, because
right,
drying out the body.
Right. When we die, there are two forces at work. The bacteria that try to eat up the body and just get rid of the tissues, and the heat, which dries out the body. If the body dries out into a leather-like condition, mm-hmm, the bacteria can't get a foothold. Mm-hmm. So that bodies in the desert are in much better condition than bodies that'll be out here in the ground in New York City, for example.
Yeah. Now, you brought a whole bunch of dirt here.
One of the things I want to say is the issue with the Manson project is that the National Park Service has control of that area, and they have to give
approval,
authorization.
Yeah.
And there's some dogs that have found some areas of possible cadaver dogs, human. What happens when you're going to dig up a body? The important thing is to get off the topsoil, because once you get off the 2 inches of topsoil, you don't have to dig everything up. If a body has been buried, if a hole is dug in the ground, like I'm doing here, and then a body is put in and the soil is reconstituted, it looks different. You never get the grains of sand and the molecules to line up.
So you'll notice something. So if you get that topsoil off,
you can tell if there's a body under there.
And after 40 years, and I know that you've done so many of these famous investigations, but after 40 years, that's just it? About 2 inches of topsoil that you think would have accumulated there that you need to get rid of?
That's right. And then you can see whether there's a hole there and whether it's been dug up. And then you have to dig down to see if there's a body there, because there can, mm-hmm, be other reasons for holes. And the National Park Service has agreed to it. What's interesting is there's a dispute with the National Park Service going on now over the body of Meriwether Lewis, of Lewis and Clark fame, who was shot in 1809 in Tennessee and is buried in Tennessee under a National Park Service property. 160 of his descendants have signed a petition to exhume the body, see if it was suicide, because they think it was a homicide. And the National Park Service has refused to honor that because they don't want to disturb National Park Service ground. And if they were able to dig up that body, they'd be able to find his bones, his teeth, and maybe and whatever clothing he had on. There's a lot of interest.
One of the most fascinating Americans, I think, in our history, in our nation's history. Boy, that would be really interesting.
Yes, and there's a real push on Professor Starrs at George Washington University is leading the charge, mm-hmm, and they keep petitioning the National Park Service in hope that...
And the family wants it done.
In 160 descendants want it done, and so the same thing is going on with the Manson case here. If they're able to dig down, and then they'll find out if anybody's been buried there.
How good are the cadaver dogs? Because, you know, after 40 years, you said it's cadaver dogs on this property, and they're indicating 5 different sites where there might be bodies buried. Yeah. How good are they?
I found in dealing with cadaver dogs, they're terrific dogs, but they often hit on false positives. You can't adopt just what they say, but it gives the investigators a clue where to look.
Okay. Dr. Michael Bodden, thank you very much.
Thank you,
Forensic Friday. You can go back and pot the petunias again with that dirt. Thank you.